I gets worse, babe.
Thank you.
Hey, there we are. I'd like to say hi to everybody. Thanks for coming out to hear us play, staying around for the second half. We're going to do something for flute and bass. You've met this gentleman before, Jared Poole. He's a Newberry College graduate, plays real good bass, plays real good trombone, guitar. Works for Thad Mays Construction. He can do heating and air conditioning. But he also has his own band, Prevalent, and they have recently recorded some stuff, and it's going to be released as a CD soon. So, if you want your copies, well, see me. I'll see if I can get some from Jim. We're going to open with something appropriate called I'm Beginning to See the Light, and this was usually attributed to Duke Ellington, but actually there were about four people that took part in this song. Duke Ellington, Johnny Hodges, Harry James, and Don George. I don't know him, but anyway, it was a big tune in the late 40s. It's on the Reader's Digest thing of top hits of the late 1940s. Harry James's band with a girl named Kitty Callan singing the words to it. Those rather exotic words, seeing moonbeams in my wine, candlelight on a mistletoe, things of that nature. And evidently, it says here in Wikipedia, Ellington's inspiration for this song was his recent initiation into Freemasonry. He was a member of Social Lodge No. 1 of the Grand Lodge of the District of Columbia. So we have that to contend with. At any rate, here's this tune, I'm Beginning to See the Light. Thank you. Sean Hare. He's been teaching for about 7 years. He has twin boys that are going into high school, getting ready to graduate from high school. What, junior? 10th grade, sophomore. That's pretty close. Yeah, one of them plays the viola, one of them plays another instrument that I suddenly can't think of. But anyway, Sean's a Newberry College graduate, and he's been playing with us for a long time. Hello, there they are. Hello, thanks. And dare I turn this? Thanks. On drums, Josh Capone. Yep. And he fittingly is a tax accountant. He does corporate income tax stuff. Does he have any connection to Newberry College? He's a friend of Martin Giles. Martin was not able to make it this time. And Martin, of course, dated and married a Newberry College girl, and so we have a very tight connection there. The tune we're going to do it's Only a Paper Moon. This was written by Harold Arlen, published in 1933. It was set for an unsuccessful Broadway play called The Great Magoo. Then it was changed. It was used in a movie called Taking a Chance. But it really got famous the last few years of World War II. Ella Fitzgerald and Nat Cole did some things with that. But the tune kept cropping up. It's been recorded by a lot of people. It's kind of a jazz standard. 1973 Oscar-winning film Paper Moon. And then it also, this song was featured in and lent its name to Star Trek Deep Space Nine episode. It's Only a Paper Moon being performed in that episode by James Darren. And also, a verse from this song was used by the Japanese author Haruki Murakami as the theme for his prize-winning epic, IQ-84. Exactly what that is, but anyway. Yes. Hello? Ah, there we are. Okay, we're going to play this tune. We'll treat it kind of reverently for one go through, and then we'll move it along a little bit. It's been around a long time. It's Only a Paper Moon. Thank you. Millie Keith, she has been with this group, not done this in a while. I think this is the 14th time we've done this. Anyway, Millie is, sings in the Columbia area, sings in a lot of different areas. She was booked with the jazz band for some time. The Newberry Commons Jazz Band did a really nice job with My Funny Valentine, lots of other things. I can remember playing a job called named Ed Crosby some years ago at Jamil Temple, here, there, and everywhere you were playing and singing that. It was very fun. Okay, we are going to do another tune. This is kind of interesting, A Bushel and a Peck. When I found out about this song, it says it's written by Frank Lesser, guy who wrote Guys and Dolls, and I said, that can't be right. I only associated it with Terry Como, Terry Como, kind of a novelty song, but actually A Bushel and a Peck was in Guys and Dolls, the stage show, but I never saw the stage show. The movie, they took it out. They changed it. So, let's see, it was performed on stage by Vivian Blaine. A Bushel and a Peck, however, was not included in the film and instead replaced by a new song titled Pet Me Papa. So, anyway, popular recording, Terry Como, we mentioned that. Also Margaret Whiting. That was quite popular at that time. The number, Bushel and a Peck, in the context of the show, can be performed either as Miss Adelaide and her chickadees, where the girls are dressed in yellow feathers, or as Miss Adelaide and the Hot Box Farmerettes, or Skippy Plantation Outfits. Sounds rather racy. It's a nice little tune. It's kind of different, the harmony and everything. It's just a nice song, and it caught on, and people have known it forever and ever. So we're going to do it with Millie, and this is our version of A Bushel and a Peck. Thank you. piece of music. Next, Little Things Mean a Lot. I always thought this was recorded sometime by Rosemary Clooney, but I think this little piece of paper I got from Wikipedia did not have a long list of everybody who did this. Anyway, Little Things Mean a Lot is a popular song written by Edith Vindman, Carl Stutz, published in 1953. This says, the best known recording of Little Things Mean a Lot by Kitty Callan. That's the girl that did Beginning to See the Light with Harry James. But I know Rosemary Clooney, I think, did it. The song lived on. It went to the country and western route in about 1978. And so it kept going. And also, of interest perhaps, Otto Leisner wrote lyrics for a Danish rendering entitled Smatting Kan Ilse Out, recorded by Raquel Raspini. So that was sometime recorded at Copenhagen, 1954. So lots of different people. And we're gonna hear Millie's version of this. A real pretty song. It's kind of a standard way of putting it together, but it does a little more. Anyway, here we are with Little Things Mean a Lot. Thank you. 1936, and somebody, Dorothy Fields, wrote the words. Anyway, it's a nice tune. It's from a movie called Swing Time, 1936. Fred Astaire wants to get to know Ginger Rogers, so he pretends he can't dance, and he falls down and does a bunch of stuff. They sing this tune while they're doing all that. Incidentally, it also has a neat spot where she's in, I don't know, one part of this room or dressing room or something, and Fred comes in, sits down at the piano, and she's actually got a face full of cold cream or something. He can't see that, but he sits down. Someday when you're not in, that's the way you look tonight. A little humor, but it's really a nice thing. Other showings of this tune? That was the theme song for the short-lived 1955-56 primetime television variety series, The Johnny Carson Show. And Nancy Walker performed the song on an episode of The Muppet Show with Fozzie Bear. So, and Barack Obama got into the act somewhere in his first inauguration, something. Starting today, we must pick ourselves up, dust ourselves off, begin the work, such and such. So that's it, except Nat King Cole's version was also featured on an episode of Breaking Bad titled Gliding Overall. So, and it's a long list of people. It's a really nice song. It's a real pretty thing. And I can't think of this fellow's name. Mel Torme. I've got a recording of him doing that where they turn it into kind of a J.S. Bach thing with well, he does some scat in the Baroque style. It's really neat. And also George, I'm digressing, but anyway, George Shearing also has a nice version of that. This is our version of Pick Yourself Up. Three different keys, and it's just kind of an interesting piece. The next tune, My Romance, is a pretty thing. Richard Rogers, Moran's Heart, was sung from something called Jumbo. I'm not too sure, that's about 1935 or so. I don't have too much information about that, except it's a very popular tune. There's a long list of people that have recorded it. I can think of one by Peggy Lee that was kind of nice and kind of an up-tempo style. And also, the song is featured in a commercial for Ralph Lauren's Romance Fragrance. So, you never can tell where some of these things are going to crop up. This is a pretty piece. I heard Bernadette Peters, it seemed like, was on YouTube. I heard a nice recording of that, a really earnest, straightforward version of that. This is our version of My Romance. Sung up, shows up twice in the play. Everybody knows most things about it. It's interesting that the song somehow was sung at association football clubs, meaning soccer teams around the world. where it is performed by a massed chorus of supporters on match day. So began with the Liverpool Football Club, was just all over the place. And also Aussie soccer got into the act doing that. So a few extra musical connections. But this is just a real beautiful song. And so here's Nellie saying, "You'll Never Walk Alone."
Start over, 'cause I'm a woman.
We look forward to seeing you all down in the lobby. We can do a little schmoozing down there. Enjoy it very much.